Ciao a tutti, my name is Stefano and here I am back with another 5 minutes dark table editing, this time on waterfalls. I'm gonna take one photo like this, I'm gonna edit it with dark table and here is the result. You see, big change, easy to do, less than 5 minutes, like get straight into dark table interface. I love this 5 minutes editing. For this editing, again, I'm gonna use the OSC editing process, which means I'm gonna work first on the overall part of the photo, then I'm gonna move to the subject, trying to put more of attention into the subject, and finally, I'm gonna control the colors. But let's get into the interface. By the way, this is a photo I did in Cuba, in the Guanayara Park, north of Trinidad, about 1 hour from Trinidad. So what's the problem with this photo? I love the photo because it is this nice waterfall which is balanced by this person here looking into the waterfall, which is a friend of mine. If you travel with me, I'm absolutely a pain. And the problem is that it's too much light. Obviously, I did this photo in the middle of the day and you can't control that. You know, if you are in a place like that, 12 o'clock during the day, what can you do? You can't wait for sunset, for a better light. You just have to move on, do the photo, and then in post-processing you can improve it, and let's see how we can do that. So first let's work on the overall photo, and the first model I want to use is the contrast, brightness and saturation. I go here, and as you see here, by the way, into the history, the only thing I did is the crop and rotate because it was a little bit bigger, but you see that this tree here was a little bit of distraction into the photo and it was too much into the sky, and this person was way too small, so I crop a little bit this photo to give more space to the person and less space to the sky. And what I want to do here is to add a little bit of a contrast into this photo, decrease a tiny bit the brightness of this photo, and also I don't like this saturation of this green. It's a bit too much, it's taking the attention away, so I'm gonna decrease also a little bit of a saturation here. I'm gonna pump up a little bit of the colors here into the subject of my photo. I'm gonna do it only at the end, in the final part of the editing. And that's pretty much it with the contrast, brightness and saturation. So I'm gonna close this module and I'm gonna now move to work on the subject, trying to get more attention into the central part, trying to dark up the foreground here and also the background there into the sky. And I want, however, to keep bright this walking path here to go into the person, because I want to create a leading line from the center of the photo to go up to the friend of mine. And to do that, I'm gonna use the exposure module. I'm gonna decrease the exposure up to a point that I see this greenery here enough actually dark, around one stop. And I want to apply only to the foreground and the background. So what I do here, I go into the parametric mask, I take the shape, and I build a sort of cone. Obviously, I have to toggle this mask, and I do that easily enough. And another thing I need to do is to work on the blurring and the feathering. But before doing that, I want to activate the mask, and I can start doing this blurring here almost to 100. And I'm going to increase a little bit also the feathering radius. The idea here is to avoid, you know, a clear border, so you can't see really the difference between the application of the module and where we don't actually apply the module. Let's take it out. And maybe we can dark up a little bit more the here of exposure, and let's see without the shape before and after. You see how, and your eye goes into here, into the walking path, into this person. We can do a little bit better, and we can do that when we dodge a little bit on the person and also on the beautiful colors that are here on the back. And now we can move to the dodge and burning into the photo, because that's where you take really the photo to the next level. Let's do first the dodge of the photo, but I want to put a comment into this photo just to say what it does. That's the cone of light. Perfect. And I'm gonna create a new instance of exposure. Now I'm gonna call this one dodge. For Dodge and Burning, I'm using one of my presets that I have here that you can download from the video description. I'm gonna put a link. So Dodge, when you apply, obviously the module is gonna dodge the all follow, but we don't do that obviously. And what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use the circle here, and I'm gonna apply a little bit of dodging on the person here and also on this part of the photo to take out the nice greenish area here and also here, and obviously also into the footpath. Let's get here, because if I do that, now you will see how there is more of a clear line to go into the person. You basically build with the light a nice leading line to the person and then to the waterfall. There is this nice connection between the two, a nice balance. I will show you later on, if I take out this person, how the photo becomes. I'm happy with the dodging, and now I'm gonna do a little bit of a burning, especially on this edge here, just because it's a bit too bright. You see how this part of the photo is taking the attention out. And to do that, obviously I'm gonna use another instance again here of exposure. I'm gonna call it burn, and I'm gonna use the burn -1, and I'm gonna use brush to brush out here and also a little bit here. Show you before and after. You see before how your attention was going a little bit on this edge and this edge as well. Add that, and clearly there is a nice line going into the waterfall. Perfect. I'm happy actually with the change that we have done to our subject. The attention is goes there. So the last thing that I want to do is controlling the color here, and I'm gonna do that with the Velvia module. I'm gonna activate this module here and let's pump it up a little bit until I see a nice colors into my photo. You see how if you go, obviously 100% is way too much, but I love the colors coming out from this part of the photo. Let's see a before and after. Perfect. I'm really happy with the job that we have done. Now I want to see a before and after the editing to see if actually we have improved the photo or we just wasted our time. Now let's go into the snapshot, compress the history here. I'm gonna take a snapshot here. I'm gonna go back to where we started, which is the crop and rotate, and let's see before where attention goes a little bit everywhere, and after the attention goes to where we want, which is the waterfall that is balanced by the person here. The last thing I want to show you is if I take out this person here, how the photo becomes, because it becomes a little bit unbalanced. And let's do that with the retouch module. I activate the retouch module here. I'm just gonna zoom in. I'm gonna take the brush here and I'm gonna brush out this person. It's gonna be very quick and dirty, so it's not something I would do if I really want to change this. So you see that if you don't have actually a person to balance this photo, it's a nice photo, but it's not as nice as if you have actually a person to balance. And that's pretty much it also about this 5 minutes editing. Did I make it into 5 minutes? I don't know, I'm gonna see later, but I hope that you enjoy the video and I'm gonna see you in the next one, hopefully next week. Bye.